Welcome back to Pathologic. After about 2 months since the last posted episode and about 3 months since I've actually played the game myself, it is finally time to continue my playthrough of Pathologic. I know, it has been so long and I'm really sorry, but finally I'm back and I'm ready to do this. I'm ready to get back into this game because I'm really excited to see what's going to happen, and we're pretty dang close to the end as well. We're on day 9 here, and there's only 3 more days after that till the end. So since it has been about 3 months, I'm going to be a bit rusty. I did refamiliarize myself with the controls of the game, and I also looked at the previous video and tried to see what was happening in the story at the time. So I've got my head kind of back into it, but it's probably still going to be a bit rough, and I might do some really stupid stuff that I've just forgotten just because I'm rusty. I don't know, I might walk into a cloud of plague or something, or forget that I have the plague spotter device. So I might do some stupid stuff, and I might have to reload if I do anything exceptionally stupid, but it should smooth out after a while, and I should be able to get back into it. So let's do this. Let me just give you a little bit of a refresher on what was happening in the story, since it has been a while for you as well as for me. So at the end of the last episode, and at the end of day 8, at the end of day 8 is when I entered the termitary for the first time. And when I went in there, pretty much the first thing that happened is I got assaulted by a bunch of those butchers, and they all started beating me up, and it looked like that was probably going to be the end of me, but I got rescued by the military. The military came in, they intervened, and they rescued me, and that was the first time the military had actually arrived in town. We had been waiting with bated breath for the military to come in, and they came in at a very opportune time. They saved my ass. So the military is now all over town. They've just set up outposts, and they're just walking around town with guns and whatnot. And now on day 9, I've woken up inside of the town hall speaking with the head military guy. I don't remember his name. But yeah, I was talking with him, and I was unconscious for most of the day. Which means now I have to do all sorts of things to finish this day. However, as you can see, where is it? P? P, there we go. As you can see, it is 2 p.m. on day 9. That's about the time I woke up, because I was unconscious for most of the day. Now it's more than half the day already gone, and I haven't had a chance to do anything because I've just been unconscious. So it's a pretty crazy day. I got knocked out, I've been unconscious, the military has moved in, there's tons of people I need to talk to, and normally I have trouble doing everything in the day. And that's starting from, like, you know, 8 in the morning or something. And now everything's changed, and I have to go talk to, like, everybody, and more than half the day is already gone. Which means this is going to be a really crazy day. I don't know if I'm going to have time to do everything, but it means I'm going to have to really maximize the, like, route efficiency of who I need to talk to and stuff. Like, I need to be really careful with time, and I can't take any time to go sleep. I mean, just to take a look at my stats, you can see my infection is fairly low, my immunity is high, so that's good. But what's bad is that my exhaustion is very high, and my hunger is also pretty high. So obviously this isn't going to be enough exhaustion to last me throughout the entire day, but I can't sleep. Not really. I don't think I have time to. So I'm actually going to take some coffee that I have. There we go. Alright, now my exhaustion's pretty good. So yeah, my hunger and my exhaustion will stay good for a while, so I'm just going to ignore those for now. I have one more thing of coffee for my exhaustion if I need it. Unfortunately, I don't have any food, so I'm going to have to buy some food. Yeah, I guess if I come across any food shops, I'll just buy some food and eat it right then and there. My health is also pretty crappy, so I'm going to go ahead and take a bandage, which I think is the only healing item I have, really. Yeah, that's it. Okay, so my health is decent, immunity is great, hunger is high, exhaustion high, infection good. So I'm in okay shape. For the moment, I don't need to worry about my stats. So let's just focus on doing what we need to do for the day. I'm just gonna run like crazy and just do this as fast as possible, because I don't know how much time I'm gonna need to do what I need to do for the day. So, at the beginning of the day, that is when I woke up at like 2 p.m., I had just like a pile of notes waiting for me in my lap. Got 3 notes from Yulia, Anna, and Lara, or Lara, rather, and then a couple invitations. So let's go ahead and read these and figure out what people want for me from the day. Oh, and by the way, just to remind you on Yulia, Anna, and Lara, those are the people that are related to the Panacea. I'm not sure if you remember that, but on day 8, the day before this, I'd found out that little Vlad had given a bunch of Panacea to Mark Immortel, and then Mark Immortel had distributed the Panaceas to, at least as far as I know, at least to Lara, Yulia, and I think Anna as well. And I talked to them about it yesterday, and they were kind of cagey about it, and they basically said, come back tomorrow, which is now today, and we'll talk about it. So I think that's perhaps what they want to talk about, something related to the Panacea or that whole business. Okay, so yeah, let's read these notes, see what they want. From Yulia. Allow me to invite you to the Trammel, Bachelor. For your own benefit, of course, since the matter I'd like to discuss has a bearing on yesterday's happenings. Make haste, Bachelor. Time is of the essence. 3 more parties are playing this particular game, and we may easily find ourselves outpaced. Okay. I wonder what the 3 other parties are. Is that the 3 families? The 3 families of this town? Not sure. Anna. I sincerely urge you to see me at the Willows as soon as you can. We have serious business that needs taking care of. Pay no heed to those slandering me. Everything is different now. The fact of the matter is, we have an opportunity to save the life of one of your closest associates. Lara. Please do come to the shelter. I know how preoccupied you are, how exhausted, but the matter is of great importance. I hope this will be the last thing I ask of you. Okay, so yeah, they all want to see me. Yulia seems like the most time-dependent. Since I say 3 other people are playing this game and time is of the essence. Everyone else says, basically, please come see me, but she's the only one that basically says, you need to come right now, or you might lose. Because you'll be outpaced in the game, whatever the game is. So I feel like I want to see her first. Not to mention, I kind of trust her the most. Not that I have particular reason to trust much of anybody, but Anna, I certainly don't trust. She's kind of slimy. Lara, I guess I trust her, but she's kind of mysterious and strange. Whereas Yulia seems to be a very clear thinker, and I don't feel like she's in anybody's pocket. Okay, Victor's invitation. I wish I could start this letter on a happier note, Bachelor, but I am utterly crestfallen. There is hardly a more harrowing discovery than to look back on the life you have lived, and to see how little you have managed to do. I'm almost out of time, and the only thing I want is to pass whatever it was that gave meaning to my existence on to somebody else. Unsurprisingly, I see no better man to confide in than yourself. Please come to see me when you can. P.S. I hope that the tower will open up before you. It is very important. That reminds me. At the beginning of this day, it gives you that little message like day 9, the day where blah blah blah. And I think what it said for day 9 is like the day where I think it said something like the day where everything changes and for the first time the children will ask for your help. And the children are, of course, their home is the tower. So I feel like the children are going to play a big part of day 9. Aglaya's invitation. Because of what happened yesterday, I can't help but feel worried about you. Please don't rush headlong into your independent investigation. Keep in mind that the army is a force to be reckoned with, and any mistake we make may well be our last. What we need to do is to wait and to collate our observations. I will be waiting for you at the cathedral. Okay, so I feel like visiting Yulia is the most important thing to do to begin with. However, if I wanted to maximize the efficiency of my route in terms of time, then the best thing to do would be to, like, start from one end and go to the other, I guess. You know, like, talk to Aglaya at the cathedral, and then talk to the Canes, and then Lara, Yulia. But, you know, Yulia's just right here, and I feel like I should talk to her first. Since she says it, 3 other people are playing the same game, I kind of want to know what she's talking about, because that might influence how I interpret the information from talking to the other people. You know, if I find out that some particular people that I'm about to speak to are playing some particular game, then perhaps I can analyze their words in a different way, you know, with more context than I would have if I didn't speak with Yulia. So yeah, let's go to Yulia first. Also, I need to see little Vlad and purchase the infection map for the day, because right now I don't know where is infected, but we'll save that for when I'm in the neighborhood. I also need food. There's a food shop over here. Let's go visit it. Yeah, so I've got to remember the little things of this game, like looking in bins to collect little knickknacks to trade with. I've got to remember that. Let's see how the prices are for this day. What are we looking at? 1600 for an egg. Okay. Well, that's great. Eggs are incredibly inefficient food, so I'm not going to buy that. And I don't need a lemon because I have coffee. Okay, yeah, I don't have time to go looking in bins for little knickknacks, though. Not enough time, so let's go to Yulia. Also, pardon me if I clear my throat sometimes. I'm still kind of recovering from a cold. Oh, right. I remember I'm supposed to go inside of clothing shops to see if I can buy any needles and stuff like that to trade with the children. Ah, two needles. Excellent. Yeah, that's fine. I'm turned around. Oh, there we go. Yeah, let's hope I still remember the geography of this town. I think so. It's kind of burned into my brain at this point. You know what I forgot? I forgot whether this game has a quick save. Does it? It does. Okay. Good.
My arms are flaccid, as if made of cotton wool.
Let's hear the rest of her dialogue. Oh, right. I can't leave the dialogue. Okay. Well, I'll redo the conversation at the end of it. So nice of you to drop by. What did your visit to the military reveal? Did you get to meet Alexander the Great? Oh right, that's his name. Or is it? Oh, I mean, it's not Alexander the Great, but was it Alexander? No, anyway. Was he a man of astute mind, vigorous imagination, and a refined sense of humor? Please be as sincere as possible. The subject is of significant interest to me. Why? My field of inquiry is ever the same. I'm testing a theory which concerns what I refer to as the trip wires of fate. You know I am a bit of a fatalist, don't you? Anyway, in order to further test my hypothesis, I will require your assistance with one of my enterprises, apart from its sheer scientific value. This whole business will rid Lara Ravel of whatever is troubling her. Moreover, with a little bit of luck, an innocent life will be saved. Oh, really? Wait till you hear this one. Lara Ravel conspires to assassinate the commander. She is so naive, our Lara. Barely able to keep her operation a secret. Half the town is aware that she seeks to purchase a firearm. No one would sell her one, of course. Really? Lara wants to assassinate the commander. Why? I remember Lara has a strange past and some weird connections to people, but I don't remember what the connections were, or if we even knew the connections. Why would you want to kill the commander? Well, if she needs a gun, honestly, I could give her one. I could. I have a pistol and a rifle. I could give her the pistol. And why has she chosen such a target? Ludicrous, is it not? The man was wounded 4 times at the Karstoff Fords, which did nothing to impede him. He emerged a victor, regardless of the grenade fragment which sat bone deep in his flesh. And there she is, expecting a hero as such to be killed by a pellet, which would hardly suffice to put a dent in his uniform. That's not what I meant. What's her problem with the commander? Perhaps she believes that he represents a kind of universal evil? An ultimate annihilator who has arrived with the only purpose of reducing the town to rubble. If only he was killed, Lara thinks, it would provide us with a much-needed delay. After all, the medicine was already researched, she thinks. Was it, though? I don't know. Just wait till you've heard it all. The commander was informed, by some unknown benefactor, that there will be an attempt on him soon. Along with everything else, the note contained a request. If the assassin proves to be a woman, she must not be killed. The weapon of the assassin, the note said, will be a harmless toy, and whoever wields it will not deserve anything more than a short-term imprisonment. And how do you know about the anonymous letter? Or are you its author? Why would you insinuate such a thing? I had absolutely nothing to do with the letter. It was someone else, someone very involved with this whole affair. Just like the rest of the parties, this person acts in good faith and conscience. Including the informer? I doubt you can convince me of that. It is well known that Block is as chivalrous as they come. If the hapless assassin is guaranteed safety, the unknown correspondent has promised to let the commander know the name of the culprit, and therefore spare him the tiresome necessity to seize every single person to appear within firing range. I don't think you'd be too disappointed to learn that the letter was written by none other than Anna. That dirty creature. Don't be too harsh on her. She's a thespian, a child, eager to entertain her whims. The assassination will be an utter fiasco. The military will be forewarned, and the gun that Lara has obtained will not fire. They will treat Lara as they treat women they believe to be hysterical or deranged. They are going to lock her up. But what does Anna have to gain from this? What is her deal? No, Yulia, you're not being entirely honest. Ask her if you don't believe me. Anna's eccentricity is borderline hysterical. She is scared, perhaps, and eager to get on the good side of whoever she believes to be holding the most authority. Yeah, I could see that. But one thing is for certain, and that is that I do not trust Anna. At all. I do not trust her. So I'm just going to assume that she's acting in bad faith. Very well, but what does this have to do with testing your fatalistic theories? The commander wants to know who the woman is. Just tell him the assassin is me. Tell him that whoever else comes to shoot him with a weapon that does not fire is merely a madwoman, keen to sacrifice herself for me. The reason I've plotted an asinine scheme like this is that I need to be placed under house arrest as soon as possible. I'd rather not tell you why I need that. Block. Oh right, Block is his name? What is his name? Is it Alexander Block, or is Alexander not even his name? I don't know. I'll find it out when I speak to him next. Okay. Well, I don't see any obvious harm from playing along with this. Honestly, putting her under house arrest might actually make her safer. I mean, that means she has bodyguards, right? Under house arrest? And what if they shoot you? The man who won the Battle of the Fours is going to shoot me? Don't be ridiculous. I have nothing at all to fear from him. Because you're a fatalist and not afraid of death, right? Don't lie to me, Yulia. This is dangerous. This is the best option, still. I know Lara too well. No one will be able to stop her. She will find a gun sooner or later. On the other hand, your cooperation may net you Anna's panacea, in addition to my own, since Anna was a third person offered a vial. Hmm. I could use more panaceas. Since I think I used the last, I think I used the last panacea that I had, right? Because I've already used my Schmouter, and I think I had some other panacea. Maybe it was the experimental one. That I got from the doctor guy whose name I forgot. I think I've used all my panaceas up. And remember, I kind of need panaceas to cure key characters, because key characters have started to come down with the plague. And I'm pretty sure if I don't cure them that day with a panacea, then they'll end up dead the next day. And yeah, if I remember right, people have told me that keeping main characters alive is important. Particularly important to get a certain ending, I guess, like a better ending. Or a more complete ending or something like that. So I'd prefer to keep everybody alive. Which means I want panaceas and I'm currently out, so this would be good. I don't know. It's too silly. There's no reason to worry. This whole affair will hurt no one. Quite the opposite, in fact. Everyone will benefit from it. Everyone, including yourself. I don't really need this vial of panacea, you see. I may be very easily persuaded to hand it over. I think I'll talk with Anna first. It seems to me that you're plotting her demise. Yes. Let's gather more information before I act. Alright, what's happened? Okay, this is a side quest, technically. It is clear that Yulia wants to shield Lara, even though she tries her best to make it look as though she expects to benefit from it. Is she really inclined to play this kind of game with fate? Her strategy is simple. She will let the commander know that the mysterious Avenger is none other than her. She expects to suffer the consequences. Okay, well, if what she said is true, then speaking with Lara about it before going to the commander and telling him would be a bad idea, because if you tip Lara off, who knows what she'll do. But I do want to speak with Anna first. But it's so inefficient to go speak with Anna right now. She's over there on that side, and then I'm gonna have to go all the way back here, and, should I just go? I'm just gonna go. I'm just gonna do it. And don't worry about that scribbling sound, by the way. That wasn't an extra note. That was just that weird bug where if you quicksave, sometimes it replays that scribbling sound. Gotta remember, I've got this thing. Let's look out for the plague. Hello. Oh. Yep. Plague is over there, of course. Okay. What's the best way to get to her house? Just go along here, I think? Yeah, I think this is fine. What time is it? 3 p.m. Okay. Still got a fair amount of time. Whoa! Okay, they're shooting somebody. Hello, plague rat. Please don't bite me. Oh, looks like they're shooting a robber. A thief. That's good.
Is disheveled and coming out.
Oh my god, I just realized I forgot to redo the conversation with Yulia to see what her audio lines would be. Oh well. People are supposed to help each other. That I firmly believe. You may perish yourself, but you should help your fellow beings. Extend a hand today to thy neighbor, and he will do the same for you tomorrow. And even if he doesn't, so what? The giver's own virtues will be his consolation all the more. Wow, she's suddenly very pious. Well, well, do go on. Your words are music to my ears. You know, Vlad the Younger recently went through a dramatic metamorphosis. His eyes burn bright, his words are brave, his acts so noble. It all paints a great picture of him. He used to be a cynical leech, and now he is a hero. So why wouldn't I follow his example? Give away what little I have left. Count me in. Right. Oh yeah, I totally believe that. She sounds like someone who thinks, like, suddenly fears that she's gonna go to hell, so she's like, oh my god, you know what, I'm a good person, I'm gonna be a great person, please don't put me in hell, God, or something like that. Sudden change of heart is less than believable. Commendable, Anna, but how are you going to do that? Well, I have procured what Lara asked for. Voila! A small weapon of self-defense. Oh, no. No need to thank me. I got it practically for free. You know, from the previous owner. Let me guess. The previous owner is now dead. But there's more. If you deliver this present to Lara anonymously, I will gladly give away the most valuable thing I own. My panacea. Oh my god. What a fucking mess. So I have Yulia, who, from what I can tell, wants to protect Lara. I have Anna, who is so kind-hearted that... So kind-hearted that she wants to give Lara a weapon so that Lara can try to assassinate the commander. Commander Alexander the Block the Great, or whatever his name is. Anna, are you really that stupid, or is this just you acting? Pardon me. You've thrown me off a bit. What are you up to? Lara needs it for self-defense. She's afraid of the soldiers. You must give it to her in secret. No questions asked and no names mentioned. When you deliver the pistol to Lara, come back for your reward. I don't mind parting with it anymore. Look, the only reason she would want this gun delivered with no questions asked, delivered anonymously, no names mentioned, is because she knows that it's going to be used for an assassination attempt. She knows it's not just for self-defense. Otherwise, why would she be so worried about her name being mentioned? I don't know. I mean, maybe there's a recent ordinance with the military that you're not allowed to carry weapons or something? I don't remember. But I'm pretty sure... I mean, come on, Anna's a schemer. She knows what's going on. That sounds mighty suspicious. Hey, it's just girl's business, alright? Girl's business. That's what you call giving a gun to someone so they can assassinate the head military guy? Girl's business? Anyway, I wanted to do a good deed for once. Wash away my old stains, so to speak. And that's what I get in return. You won't even appreciate my sacrifice. And I promise to give you the panacea, the sample that I got from Vlad the Younger. So if what Yulia said is not true, what if Yulia is not trying to protect Lara? If she's not trying to protect Lara, if Lara doesn't actually intend to use the weapon in an assassination attempt, then what does that mean? I guess that means that she probably does just want it for self-defense, in that case. So what would that mean? Yulia wants Lara to not be able to defend herself? Yulia would want Lara dead? In that case? That just doesn't seem likely. I don't know. I feel like Yulia's probably telling the truth, and that Lara does want the gun for an assassination attempt, and that Yulia does want to actually protect Lara. Or maybe by placing herself under house arrest, she wants to protect herself? Maybe she believes someone's gonna come for her? And by being under house arrest, she'll be protected? I don't know. There's games within games going on here that these people are playing. Or at least I suspect so. So, do I say I should speak with Lara first, or do I say just give me the thing? I mean, I could always accept the thing and then just not give it to her. Right? Right? I mean, would there be any... Would anything bad come from that? Would Anna never speak with me again because I didn't deliver it? I feel like nothing bad would actually happen if I did that. Well, I want to take the gun off of her hands regardless, even if I don't actually give it to Lara, and I most likely won't give it to her. But one thing's for sure, and that's I don't want Anna to have it, so yes, please give it to me. Oh, right, I don't have room. Okay, I don't need a million lockpicks. Let's dump that. Oh, it's
I don't want to undress. What if there's something scary on my skin?
It's a mini weapon. Wait. Oh, that doesn't actually count as a weapon. Interesting. It counts as, other, apparently. Okay.
I could have been a famous singer.
Do I need these bloods? I already checked this, right? I think I checked it. God, I'm scared that I didn't, though.
My hair is disheveled and coming out.
I'll just dump an empty bottle. Just to be safe. Okay, there we go. Alright, there it is. Yeah, that's a pathetic weapon. There's no way she could kill the commander with that. Let's check her lines of audio dialogue.
Whose child was crying there?
Why do you look at me with such disapproval? Have I done something wrong? Well knows the kitten whose meat it has eaten, Anna. Ever heard this proverb? I have no idea what that means.
My hair is disheveled and coming out. Have you met ominous people in circus costumes here? What?
Okay. Okay. Did I just actually get a new note? The three parse. Anna participates. Anna asked me to give a small pistol to Lara, ostensibly for protection, but the reward she is promising is too much for such a simple errand. Okay, yeah. Anna definitely knows, even the quest itself is suggesting it. Now the big question is... The big question is, do I go see Lara first, before talking to the commander and telling her, or telling the commander about Yulia, you know, lying that Yulia is the one who's going to try to assassinate him? Because I'm probably going to do that. I'm most likely going to do that. What would I do with Lara? Like, I don't even want Lara to know, because who knows what she might do. If she knows that I'm onto her, maybe she'll do something crazy. Go back inside where it's quieter, and let's check the note that I got from Lara. Matters of great importance, I hope this will be the last thing I ask of you. Yeah, see, Lara intends to die, doesn't she? I hope this will be the last thing I ask of you. And of course, she wants me to get her a weapon, I'm guessing. Yeah. So then that means there's no point in going to talk with her first, right? Because I know she's just going to ask me for a weapon, and I know what she intends to do with it, and I don't want her to do that with it. Is Lara one of my, adherents? I forgot. She's not. But she's still an important person, and I still don't want her to die. Town Hall first or Lara? Town Hall first or Lara? Which one? I'm going to the Town Hall. Gonna save it, perma-save it, just in case I regret this. Oh yeah, this place isn't actually filled with the plague, is it? This is, the plague has just gone out of this place. Kind of status, where everything's yellow and there's plague rats, but no actual plague. Yeah, I really don't feel like talking with Lara would be productive at all. I feel like I already know enough. But what if I mentioned it? What if I talked with her about it? If I told her I know what she's planning on doing, what would she do? Try to go at the commander with a knife or something? Get herself killed anyway? Nah, it's too dangerous. Too dangerous. I'm going straight to the town hall. Finally figure out what this guy's name actually is. Commander Blockhead Alexander. Alexander the Mediocre.
We fought a just, defensive war, and now they want to turn us into a punitive expedition. Into Causeman.
Your name is Commander? That's not... Oh, hold on. There's a list of people's names somewhere, isn't there? I don't remember where it is. Whatever.
We need to go back to the front.
There's going to be an attempt on your life. Have you been told already? I seem to have found myself in the middle of a funny story or someone's idiotic practical joke. I received a letter, clearly penned by a deranged woman. It warns me about some sort of vigilante in a painfully high-strung manner. The vigilante is herself, right? I can say it's Anna. It would be pretty funny to pin it on Anna, wouldn't it? I almost want to do that just to mess with Anna because I hate Anna and I kind of want to see what happens, but let's not do something just for the fun of it. This isn't the sort of game where you do something just for the fun of it. No, the vigilante is a much more significant woman. I fear only one woman in this town. And if she chooses to try for my life, so long me. But I don't think she would use such extravagant means to achieve that end. Her name is Yulia. She suffers from a neurotic condition. Fine. I'll send Rifleman there immediately. Let her be under house arrest until I have time to make a closer acquaintance. One more thing. The gentler half of the town community is already abuzz with the news. So should any overexcited lady come here? I understand. She will be treated with utmost respect. I will talk to her and do my best to set her right. But if she turns violent, she will be locked up. Alright, that's okay. Just don't shoot her, please. Thank you, Commander. Oh, boy. What have I done? Right thing, wrong thing, who knows? I don't know. Alright, let's see what's happened. With hardly any consideration, the Commander sent an outfit of his riflemen to Yulia's place. Could it be that she merely wanted armed protection around the clock? That's what I was thinking. If this is the case, I'd better take the panacea from her. Who knows if her academic fervor will compel her to test the cure on one of the guards. Yeah, so I still need to go get the panacea from her. Maybe I should have gotten the panacea first. I don't know if the guards are gonna get in the way now. Let's go check. God, this game is so uncomfortable to play. And I mean that in a good way. Like, I'm messing around in things. I'm mucking around in all these situations, all these relationships, and just... Like, I'm... Whoa, whoa, whoa. What's up? Whoa, what the... Huh? What? I'm sorry. I know they're armed guards and they're supposed to guard her, but... what exactly was it about me existing in the area of the house that made them think I was a threat? Okay. You know what? I think I'm gonna get the panacea from her before I tell the commander. I'll be right back. Okay, well, I loaded my save game, and I went back and I talked to Yulia before talking with the commander. And it turns out you actually can't get the panacea until you've talked with the commander. I guess she wants you to have actually done the job before she'll give it to you. Which means I still need to make it past the guards. And, like, I'm thinking maybe I'm just not even supposed to talk with her, but... she did tell me she'd give me the panacea, and the quest even says... if she just wanted arm protection around the clock, then I'd better take the panacea from her. Which suggests that... like, the quest even suggests that I should go to her and take the panacea. So why do the guards want to kill me, and how do I get past them? Let's find out. Are they going to start running at me again? The good thing is they don't shoot me. Do I have to, like, sneak or something? There's no way I can sneak past all those guards. Look at them. Yeah, okay. Alright, I'm just gonna see if I can run inside of her house while five people try to beat me with their buttstocks. Good job, guards. Can't even open a door to defend her from the inside. Why do they want to kill me? I don't understand. They don't want to kill me just when I enter the yard. They want to kill me when I'm even on the street.
I should let some fresh air into the room, but I don't feel like it.
I got the jitters. What with all this excitement? Fortunately, everything seems to have worked just as it was intended to. If for a single minuscule blunder. What blunder? Shots were fired. What was it all about? Well, they actually didn't fire their weapons, otherwise I'd be dead, but, let's play along with it. Your new friends fired at me. Did they now? And you were perfectly able to defend yourself, I presume. All of them are dead. No? I just ran past them. Yulia, just be honest with me. Why are you doing this? My calculations were compromised by a factor I could not anticipate. Apparently it's best not to involve you in any affairs that have to do with fate and the diversity of its manifestations. I owe you a vial of panacea then, don't I? Best not to involve you in any affairs that have to do with fate. Interesting, I guess I'm too unpredictable? Well, I want to tell her don't trouble herself, but... damn it, I worked hard for that panacea. Yes, please. Exactly. Let's take a look at that. Organic serum based on antibodies that Artemy Barak managed to procure from some mysterious source. Yes, yes, fascinating. Completely eradicates the effects of the infection at any stage. Is not harmful. Only a few portions exist in the town. Probably no more than a dozen. That is indeed very valuable. Okay, now I've got to run from them again. Wow. Oh, that AI. Okay, they're not going to leave me alone until I get inside of something, so let's go inside of the clothing store. Oh my god! What the? I thought... shit. I thought their positions reset. How am I gonna ditch them? Fuck. If they're gonna follow me everywhere, I need to get, like, go inside of a place that has a back exit so that I can ditch them. Oh, fuck. Okay. Well, that's not gonna work. I'm, like, 90% dead already. Yeah, I think I need to go inside of a house that has a back exit or something. Otherwise, I don't think I'm gonna be able to ditch them. Oh, fuck! No! Fine, I'll live with it. Assholes. I'll live with being dead, almost. Okay, well, I guess I'm just gonna ignore their existence and go to my next location. I don't really have time to deal with them. Alright, I need to speak with the Inquisitor, and I also need to speak with, Victor Kane. Yeah, so let's go speak with Victor Kane. Guard, can you please shoot the other guards? No, I guess not. Oh god, don't tell me. Oh, fuck, I'm going into a plague district. Great. Great. Honestly, it'd be better to go over here and then go across the bridge. Alright, don't hit me, don't hit me. Okay, whew, I'm okay. Actually, is it better? I don't know. I thought I'd avoid more to the plague, but maybe not. Okay, I think I'm okay? Yeah, I'm okay. It's funny how no one thinks there's anything odd going on. Like, you think at least the other guards would join in to support their friends, but they're not joining in or stopping them. It's like, I'm not paid enough to deal with this. Is that more plague over there? Yeah, it is. Okay, does this place have, like, a back entrance? I don't think these places do, actually. Oh my god. Does any place have a front and a back entrance, actually? Like, I really don't know. I can't think of a single one. They're not gonna be with me for the rest of the game, are they? I almost got them stuck on the geometry there. This is ridiculous. I'm sorry, I'm like accidentally ruining the tone of the game with the ridiculousness of this whole AI thing. Alright.
It's like something is pulling my strings.
There you are, Bachelor Dankovsky. You see, I wanted to avoid all the unnecessary sentimental talk. But it has come to be that the Canes are getting ready to sleep. And it will come to be that only Maria will rise from that sleep. If you leave us, we will probably perish. What does that mean? Are you intending to die? We are back at the starting point now. We deal with the issue of death differently. When the original identity is extinguished, and an entirely new one arises in its place, is that death? Is madness not a form of death? Is loss of memory not the true death? That's just philosophy. Surely you didn't summon me here for that. Indeed. You see, I'm out of means to influence my son. Now that the town is occupied by soldiers, he is going to turn the polyhedron into a fortress under siege, which will infuriate the army. I fear that his ill-advised actions may result in the tower's destruction. Okay, how can it be prevented? The polyhedron conceals a secret. It is unknown whether it came to be by accident or as part of some ingenious design, but it works. I don't know if it will be revealed to you. I would like you to go inside and convince yourself of the truth of my words. That is my desire as well. And if you succeed in gaining little Casper's confidence, I ask you do one last farewell favor for our family. Help me make peace with my son. Convince him to listen to me. Okay, so this is how the tower and the children are getting roped into the story for today. Because I knew they'd be important, but now I know how. And what do you want him to do? When the time comes, and it will come in as little as 2 days now, the children must leave the polyhedron. Otherwise, my daughter Maria could die. And my and Georgie's passing would also be in vain. What would Maria die? Because she will then be forced to become my successor, to take up what I currently guard, and thus condemn herself to death, and our family to extinction. Maria will die, and the wondrous spirit whose memory we have so carefully passed on will vanish into nothingness. I don't understand. Do you believe that it's possible to manipulate reincarnation? No. Not only do we believe in it, but we have successfully practiced it for 5 generations. Don't ask me about the details. That would be too naive and beside the point. I beg of you, convince Casper to open the polyhedron to us when the time comes. I will try. It is my longtime wish to get inside the polyhedron. Okay, the guards are gonna be right outside. I gotta watch out for them. Only other major person to talk to out here, aside from going to the tower, of course, is the Inquisitor at the cathedral. So let's go there. Oh god. Oh god. Yeah, okay. Is it actually possible for me to live? They're kind of blocking the way. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. This might be really bad. Can I jump over their heads? I don't think I can. Oh! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Okay, wow. I'm close to dead, but I made it. Ooh. Save again. Get stuck on the geometry! Oh, okay. I just died again, but I just realized I can jump over the pillar. Which is good, because I can do that back here. In fact, I might even be safe on the pillar. Could I use the pillar to dodge them? Let's try the pillar dodge strat. Yes, yes, yes. Oh my god, I think this is actually gonna work. Yeah! Okay, they're all stuck there. Now I enter back in here. Let's save. Now I'm gonna go out here and I'm gonna sneak right away, and maybe they won't see me. Oh god, nope. Didn't work. Okay. I think they might actually be with me for the rest of the day. Oh my god. Wow, yeah. It seems like they're almost hard-coded to be on my ass the whole time. Like, I can't even sneak around them. Okay, well, I've got a head start. Let's go. Hey, at least 2 of them are still stuck.
No. He hates us already. He'll raise us to the ground and kick his own grave before going down.
I have disturbing news. Barak's disappeared. What do you mean? He went to the termitary on my assignment, and still has not returned. Problem is, I had special hopes for his assignment. He was supposed to not only report to me about the inner workings of this abattoir, if you will, but also bring one other thing. What thing? Panacea. Today, Barak was going to perfect a remedy that would heal anyone sick with the sand pest, however grave their condition. That's not true. The final remedy formula was completed the day before yesterday. Can I count on you? Only if you drop the act and start telling me everything. Please tell me this is gonna work. I don't know if it worked. It's not just about the panacea. Barak is much more significant than many would care to admit, including himself, perhaps. Could you please inquire about him? I don't doubt his word, but he could have run into some unforeseen danger because of his invention. Do you understand? I'm not exactly keen to go inside of the abattoir. I don't know if I can make it inside the abattoir, unless perhaps you provide me with military support. Getting soldiers is not so simple. They won't listen to me, and Block, who seems to have no intentions to listen to me either. But I'm not asking you to descend into that underground pagan shrine. Just inquire about Barak, if you have an opportunity. Okay, well, I'll ask anybody that I see. That's not hard to do.
There's little time left, and I still need to do so much.
That's exactly how I feel. My yesterday's visit to the abattoir was unsuccessful. Yes, I'm aware of that. Well, we're all making a gamble here, but Barak has agreed to help me out. The residents of the abattoir accept him as one of their own, and aren't as hostile to him. I'd even go as far as to say that he's on good terms with the people who manage the biorhythms of that stone belly. Stone belly? No kidding. It does seem to kind of quite literally be a stomach or something like that, doesn't it? Given the map. Does he go there regularly? Yes, several times a day. We can learn everything we need from him. But can we his words be trusted? Interesting wording there. Absolutely. Both his words and his deeds. Well, I'll trust your insight, then.
No. He hates us already. He'll raise us to the ground and kick his own grave before going down.
See if any of these lead to anything interesting. Power can take very different shapes. Are you talking about Block? I never imagined that he hated me so much. Why? What did I ever do to him? I was expecting some instinctive resentment as part of the age-long conflict between the military and the Inquisition, but Block, it seems, would happily have my head on a platter. What might be the reason? I wonder that myself. For a moment, I thought he was driven by the same feeling that I am. A great man, when unexpectedly betrayed by the people he loves, will often seek to fill the whole universe with his blind spite. Yes, the feeling is indeed familiar. Does he consider himself betrayed? Come now, Denkovsky. They threw us all in the fire, hoping that we burn to death while simultaneously putting the flame out with our very bodies. What I'm really wondering is whether the intention to destroy the town is the product of his own judgment, or comes from the powers that be. Can a commanding officer charged with a mission like this act on his own judgment? Block would. He has become full of himself, drunk on his own glory. I have no doubt that he already dreams of himself becoming head of the government or some sort of emergency committee, a consulate at the very least. Besides, who's to say he wasn't instructed to act according to the circumstance? Just like you and me. Given the pro forma freedom to decide, but left with no choice in reality. Don't you think a situation like this would be infuriating to a clever commander like him, who also has the troops' undying loyalty and armaments such as have been shown to us? Free to surround, to die, but never to fire. Until you, Aglaia, declare that the town is saved. Understandably, he resents the situation, and extends his resentment to you.
Why are they playing me up?
Okay, I don't think these are gonna lead anywhere. Nope, this one does. The power of knowledge will always find a way to trump the force of arms. And I hope to demonstrate that to the military in no uncertain terms. With your kind assistance, of course. How can I help you? First of all, you could collect detailed data on that peculiar structure. I mean, the polyhedron. That was exactly my plan. Do not worry, I'm already working on it. Wonderful. Let everyone do what they're best suited for. Mysticism is for the mystics, the depths of the earth and their relics for the true believers, and intellectual paradoxes for the intellectuals. The abattoir will reveal itself to Barak, while that strange tower, I believe, will reveal itself only to you. That does sound plausible, doesn't it? That it would reveal itself only to me, because, after all, if I remember right, a while ago when I visited the tower, I discovered that I see... the tower looks different to me than it does to everybody except the children. Right? Because I thought, if I remember right, normal people see the polyhedron as a reflection of themselves. If I remember right, I think that's what they saw. And I forgot what the children see. But yeah, normal, like, adults see it, I think, as a reflection of themselves. Whereas when I went there, I saw it as blueprints. Literally blueprints. It was literally constructed out of blueprints. Or like, or maybe not literally blueprints, but like construction paper. I don't think it was blue, it was like just white or gray. But yeah, like construction paper. That's what I'm hoping for as well. I was just going to discuss this with Victor Kane. Well, actually, I wasn't. I already did.
What?
Alright, that's the end of that. Alright, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end this episode. Yeah, for a reintroduction to the series, for the first time I've played in about 3 months, I'd have to say that actually didn't go too bad. We do have the awkward situation of having guards following us forever, but, you know what? The next place I need to go is to the Polyhedron. I need to go speak with Victor's son there. Casper, I think his name was. I need to go speak with him and see if I can convince him to be receptive to his father. So that's the next place I need to go, and you know what, let's see if I can ditch the guards along the way, because I'm pretty sure the guards will not be able to follow me up there, because it's like ridiculously perilous, the stairways up there. Or maybe they will follow me, but they'll fall off, I don't know. Either way, we'll see you in the next episode. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll be back soon.